learners, today in this class, we are going to discuss about construction and use of achievement test. Construction and use of achievement test will help you to know how to construct and how to apply and adopt this achievement test in your class. But before going to the construction and use of it, let us know the real meaning of the achievement. The dictionary meaning of the word achievement is a thing somebody has done successfully, especially using his own efforts and skill. That means in achievement, there has to be one's own effort and skills. Let us take an example. A student in class 6, if he can solve 10 varieties of problems relating to simple and compound interest successfully, but in the same class, another student can solve it only 4 varieties. In that case, we can say that the first student has better achievement than in solving problems on simple and compound interest. He could achieve more because he had acquired more knowledge, more understanding and skills in the concept of calculating interest in different contexts than what the second student had acquired during the same time. So, achievement in this case is acquisition of experience to solve problems. In order to assess the learning achievement of the student, usually what we do, we use tests in our schools. Such tests are prepared by you or supplied to you by authorities or procured from the open market. In what ways these tests prepared by you are different from others? Do the tests procured from the market serve your purpose? Just critically think on these issues. Most of the time, teachers depend upon tests to know what extent the students have been successful in the teaching learning process and to what extent the learning objectives were achieved by the students. So the test results are reflected in the form of scores, commonly known as either grade or marks. Let us consider one example here. Suppose you are teaching mathematics in grade 2 and on addition of 2 or more than 2 numbers which deals with the concepts like addition of 2-digit numbers without carryover, addition of 2-digit numbers with carryover, then row-wise addition of 2-digit numbers and word problems on addition of 2-digit numbers. Let us take a look at the chart that I have prepared for you today. In this chart, the examples of row-wise addition of 2-digit numbers I have given, suppose 10 stars, row-wise I have arranged like this, and 15 row-wise stars I have arranged like this. Now, in order to show your grade 2 students the row-wise addition of 2-digit numbers, first you have to arrange the rows like this of 10 stars, then the 15 stars of rows like this, which makes 10 plus 15 equal to 25. Then regarding addition without carryover, suppose 23 plus 12, it makes, there is no carryover problem here because 3 plus 2 is 5, there is no carryover here, and 2 plus 1 will be 3. And with carryover, there is an example I have given you here, that is suppose 17 plus 13. 7 plus 3 makes 10, 0 we drop here, then 1 will be carried over to the next row. This is 1 plus 1 plus the carryover 1, it makes number 3. So total 17 by 13 is equal to 30. Let us see this and practice this on the blackboard. Suppose here in the chart, I have made 10 plus 15 is equal to 25. You are to arrange the row-wise number of 10. Suppose 10 stars I am taking here in this same row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. This equals to 10 number. Then I have to add 15 more stars here in order to show the total of 25. Let us go for that. 1 plus 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This makes number 15. Now 10 plus 15, it makes 25. Learners, this is a very good example to show or make the grade 2 students to learn how 10 plus 15 makes 25. That too is row wise. Now the example of addition without carryover. Suppose we take number 13. 13 plus 12 we take. 3 plus 2 is 5. Because there is no carryover, that is why 1 plus 1 will be 2. So 25, this is a good example of without carryover. Then with carryover, 17 plus 17 we give 7 plus 7 will be 14, 4 will come here, 1 will be carried over, this 1 left over 1 will be carried over on the left side, 1 plus 1 plus 1 makes 32. So these are two different examples of with carryover and without carryover. So learners, this will be a good example for your students to make them clearly understand about the same addition but with different situation. After teaching this concept, now you want to know the amount of experiences of addition acquired by each individual students. In such situation, what we do, we usually use achievement tests, because here the learner's own skills and effort will be much required to the teacher to know his actual achievement. So the teacher knows the extent of learning achievement of the students with respect to the expected learning outcome, covering knowledge, understanding, application, analysis, synthesis, and evaluation skills. Such type of test also helps the teacher to compare the performance of students' achievement with the performance of other students' achievement. Now let us know little bit about uses of achievement test in the classroom situation at elementary school level. Now suppose you have constructed a good test in mathematics for class 5 in your school. You know your students very well, and the test that you have developed gives you the required information about their achievements in mathematics. You are very satisfied with the performance of the test. Now, can this test be used by another teacher serving in the school at a far distance place or in the tribal area of your state or in school situated in a city? Well, that cannot be made sure. At the best, we can say that the test can work equally well if the students and the school conditions are as same as your school. But in the common examinations, only one set of tests is used in all schools throughout your state. These tests are carefully constructed following a strict process called standardization, so that it is fair for all students studying in schools situated widely apart in the state. Thus, there are two categories of test. One is called teacher-made test and the other is called the standardized test. So these two are the two different categories of our tests. One is called teacher-made test, which is very commonly used by the teacher in all the grades of students. Then your standardization of tests. These are the two categories of tests we generally find in the schools. The test that is used in annual secondary school certificate examination in all secondary schools of your states are example of standardized achievement test. Though the process of standardization, some properties of the test are ensured. And these properties are, firstly, number one, test items are properly designed. So the test items that are used should be purposefully designed to measure the clearly defined achievement domain. Second one is that test items are based on standard content. The test items always should be based on the standard content because it confirms the provision of using identical test and thereby confirming the provision of using identical test to different individuals in different places at different times. Then, thirdly, the test can be administered under same condition. This is a very important property of a standardized achievement test. The test always, it can be administered precisely under the same situation or conditions. And lastly, the standardized procedure of administering, scoring and interpreting the results of the test are followed. So, the standardized achievement test consists of high quality test items which are developed by specialists, tried out and selected on the basis of difficulty level. However, such standardized tests have limited use in monitoring the learning process and using them for further learning of the students. So, dear learners, let us summarize the class by knowing what are the important things we have learned in this class. We have learned in this class how to prepare the different kinds of achievement tests in the different class categories. For example, that I have given a grade 2 class of mathematics, how to give them the numerical ideas. Then I have given you the uses, maximum uses of achievement tests. And lastly, what are the properties of the standardized achievement tests? That's all for today. Thank you very much.